Blog Talk Radio.
Malachi.
You don't understand, see, you don't get it.
People don't understand,
I'm
man.
I'm a free man, and I don't mean just out of jail. I am.
They just don't understand. Corey Jackson, man. More mad than ever. How many more, man? My boy, my brother. We gotta get out of stop, man. We gotta get free.
I have
got to. Gotta put a stop to it. We gotta get free, man. Gotta get free. We can't keep doing it. This tale is ill, the autobiographic is real. So I share it from deep in my memory film. 11:40:35, then scribed on his khaki suit. I sat across from my brother, trapped in a sterile room. Different families around, attempting to heal wounds. Conversation by the hour for dark souls to sue. But this case is different, it's hella treacherous niggas. Cowards my brother trusted that became his false witness. Picture this, a small town, locale with southern states. And that serves as the framework that outlines the case. The murder took place, victim of another race. She had status and spoke to governors face to face. More fuel for the flames of supremacy and hate. That blacks will never escape without God's grace. On the court date, they brought him in shop and he took the stand. Third black boy being charged for death by one hand. An argument in another state that wouldn't have a chance. But the Commonwealth of Kentucky is a southern land that still got problems with brothers from the motherland. They judge us not by character, but by skin. But in this case, it was one Negro head. They said similar to his in the car where she disappeared. Funny how many black got similar hair. We unlucky. Evidence they use when they argue that trial, but never tested DNA and put it on file. It's all foul and wow. 50 years they gave him. Throughout trial, never showed his involvement with the plan. Just hearsay from inmates and the main suspect.
You don't understand. You don't get it. I'm a free man, and I don't mean just out of jail. I am free at last.
Gotta get free, man. Be more substantial evidence, man.
Testimony from local bums in a segregated city is the evidence they use to convince the jury committee. But really, that's only the second level of injustice. The first level was the lie detector test they shuffled. The main suspect failed too.
He failed too.
But detectives lied to the judge to get a warrant through. For who? You guessed it, my brother's name in the loop. The table now set for Southern hospitality suit. And they be cooking black boys by ones and groups. Straight out their youth, they stamp them by stretching the truth. But don't get it twisted, I hate anything that's corrupt. But when the government is guilty, tell me who can you trust?
Nobody.
Now 14 of the 50 years, my brother is done. And never had nothing to do with the death of the gun. But was violently prosecuted by a snake with a tongue. No wonder we burn with hatred like the rage of the sun.
I'm over here.
Let me ensure that I am through walking on the wild. That's all I've been trying to tell you. I have been sick with the social ills.
Shalom, Israel, and to everyone else, good evening, good afternoon, good morning to you and yours. How you doing out there? I hope you are warm wherever you are on this world's wide web. You are listening to CSI, Crime Scene Investigation, the Lost Book Series, tonight, The Apocalypse of Peter. If you'd like to join in on our show conversation while we are here live, you can give us a call at 347-205-9279 or just join us right here in the chat room at blogtalkradio.com/menempower. We will get started momentarily. Just want to remind you that you can always hit us up here when we're not on the air at area code 504-484-9388 or 601-297-2927, and our email address is menempoweredtoprosper@yahoo.com. The music we've had starting out is from Rare Jewels, The Struggle, based on a true story. The brother is named Clarence, the one that rests. He's been with us for quite some time, you definitely want to check him out. Rare Jewels and the Rare Jewels Mixtape. Just want to remind you real quickly that you can always follow along with the Men Empowered organization at menempowered@twitter.com. And yes, we are Men Empowered too on instagram.com. And don't forget, once again, our email address is menempoweredtoprosper@yahoo.com. We're going to get underway momentarily, but let's pay some bills and do a commercial right here on CSI, Crime Scene Investigation.
Finally, the long-awaited mixtape from A.G. Gatling is here, bringing an urban contemporary gospel flavor with songs like Tonight, the title track, Oh Yeah, featuring TK and Understand.
And you can find that at iTunes.com.
This is a Radio App Productions, sponsored by A.G. and Big C. And we got A.G. along. To come and preach to y'all. So throw your hands out your sunroof. Turn your stereos up. And listen to this. AG, preach.
I know I got a lot going in my mind. But Bill or do can't make ends meet. Stressing all the time, ain't gotta die. Can somebody tell me why? I get up every day, pray God stay in my way. So that I won't lose my mind. Driving from A to B, go home, got kids to feed, but with faith I'm gonna make this cry. When the best ain't good enough, and you feel like giving up, throw your hands up high and say,
oh yeah.
When the best ain't good enough, and you feel like giving up, throw your hands up high and say,
oh yeah.
Your best ain't good enough, and you feel like giving up, throw your hands up high and say,
oh yeah.
When your best ain't good enough, and you feel like giving up, throw your hands up high and say,
oh
yeah. GK say,
you good ain't good enough, and your hood ain't hood enough. You spent your whole life blowing your high, but then you down trying to figure out why. But all this sinning really making you a slave. You need to get it tight, walk right in the light. Follow his word, gotta win that fight. You modify the flesh, then you take it to the grave. Chase that high, then you lost every day. You cover by the blood, oh yeah, that's the way.
When your best ain't good enough, and you feel like giving up, throw your hands out high and say,
oh yeah.
When your best ain't good enough, and you feel like giving up, throw your hands up high and say,
oh yeah.
When your best ain't good enough, and you feel like giving up, throw your hands up high and say,
oh yeah.
When your best ain't good enough, and you feel like giving up, throw your hands up high and say,
thank you. every Saturday right here on the Blog Talk Radio Network at blogtalkradio.com. You can hear great music like that on our Hebrew and gospel outlet. We call it Saturday Night Gospel Jam. Every Saturday at 10 p.m. Central Standard Time, right here, brought to you by the Men Empowered Radio Show on the Blog Talk Radio Network at blogtalkradio.com. Kind of pepping you up. Here in the Great South, we are under a winter freeze. Now, you all know that I do a lot of promoting up north in Greater Detroit, as well as in Chicagoland area. You know it's cold up there. This down here doesn't even compare to the cold up north. But it's all good. I know how you work it deep south. We're going to work it out, and we're going to get through these next 2 days with our little ice and our little snow. Well, we're going to go ahead and get into the apocalypse of Peter. If you're joining with us for the very first time and you do not have these books, well, you came to the right place at the right time. The apocalypse of Peter. Three different apocalypses surviving from ancient Christianity claims to have been written by Peter. The one presented here was discovered in 1887 in the tomb of a Christian monk, along with the Gospel of Peter. It was subsequently found in the Fuller Ethiopic translation. The apocalypse was well known in early Christianity. Some churches counted it among the New Testament scriptures. Eventually, though, it came to be excluded from the canon, in part because Christians realized that it was promiscuous. Even then, however, the book continued to exercise significant influence on Christian thought. This is the first Christian writing to describe a journey through hell and heaven, an account that inspired a large number of successors, including, ultimately, Dante's Divine Comedy. Now, you all know that we want you to be the judge of these books. We here are going to just let you be the judge. We want to present it to you and let you be the judge of these books. Now, we've just got through the apocalypse of Elijah, and we read the first part of Elijah where he talked about the fast. Now, you all need to go back to that particular lesson when we did it on the apocalypse of Elijah part one. If you all been with me for quite some time, you know how I feel about the fast and what the fast has done for me, my family, and my outlook among what I believe, according to the cause. When you go on a fast, as in what Elijah said, that sin has to depart from you. It opens up a clear channel. It puts you into the throne room. You're not in the outer courts. You're on the inner courts of the Most High when you do this fast. You got to go back and look at the apocalypse of Elijah. Now, getting back to the apocalypse of Peter, our introductory, giving you an outline of it and a description of it. The book begins with Peter and the other disciples on the Mount of Olives, listening to Christ deliver his apocalyptic discourse. See Mark 13. Peter asks about the coming judgment. Christ responds by describing the terrifying events that will occur when the world is destroyed by fire at the last judgment. He then details the eternal torment that awaits those that's destined for hell and the perpetuity blessings of those that's bound for heaven. There is some ambiguity over whether Christ actually takes Peter on a journey through these two abodes of the dead or simply describe them in such vivid details that it feels as if Peter is seeing them. There's no ambiguity, however, concerning the respective fates of those destined for one place or the other. In an unsettling way, the horrific punishment of the damned are made to fit their crimes. Those who have followed Christ and keep the commandments of the Most High, however, will be brought into the eternal. They will enjoy the blissful life of heaven forever. Now, you know that we're going to be here on earth, so I'm assuming that this is like heaven on earth. The book ends with Peter describing firsthand what he saw on the Mount of Transfiguration, possibly in order to validate the legitimacy of the rest of his vision. Second Peter 1:17-18. The ultimate goal of this firsthand description of hellish and heavenly relatives is reasonably clear. The way to escape eternal torment is to avoid sin. Now that right there says enough right there. Avoid sin. So with all these traps that sin traps us into, to what I say, what the church fails to do is fast regularly. Now, you all know my story, my journey that I've had through the religious through the religious sayings that I've been through, far as growing up a Baptist with my family, getting in dialed into the TV ministries, going into the charismatic movement, going then into the non-denominational word of faith movement, and now here I am today of knowing the absolute knowledge and truth of the Most High. Now, it will behoove you to go back to listen to my journey to see where I'm coming from, to get my mindset, to see what I see through my eyes. And you may be person as well. Come to find out, you may go through some of the situations that I go through. So listen to that. That is featured on our website right here at Blog Talk Radio. That is one of our featured shows that we did about a year or so ago. So let's get into chapter 1 of the Apocalypse of Peter. The second coming of Christ and resurrection of the dead, which Christ revealed through Peter to those who died for their sins. Because they did not keep the commandments of the Most High, their Creator, and he, Peter, pondered thereon, that he might perceive the mystery of the Son of God, the merciful and lover of mercy. And when the Lord was seated upon the Mount of Olives, his disciples came to him. And we besought and entreated him severely and implored him, saying to him, declare to us what are the signs of your coming and the end of the world, that we may perceive and mark the time of your coming and instruct those who come after us, to whom we preach the word of your gospel and whom we install in your church, that they, when they hear it, may take heed to themselves and mark the time of your coming. And our Lord answered us, saying, take heed that no one deceive you, and that you be not doubters and serve other gods, Many shall come in my name, saying, I am the Christ. Believe then not. Believe them not. Neither draw near to them. For the coming of the Son of God shall not be plain, but as the lightning that shines from the east to the west, so will I come up on the clouds of heaven with a great host in my majesty, with my cross going before my in my majesty, shining seven times brighter than the sun, will I come in my majesty with all my saints, my angels. And my Father shall set a crown upon my head, that I may judge the quick and the dead, and recompense everyone according to his works. Alrighty, let's go to, I believe we are in chapter 2 now. And you learn a parable from the fig tree. As soon as its shoots have come forth, and the twigs grown, the end of the world shall come. And you all know who that fig tree is. That fig tree is the children of Israel waking up. And I, Peter, answered and said to him, interpret the fig tree to me. How can we understand it? For throughout all its days, the fig tree sends forth shoots, and every year it brings forth its fruit for its master. What then does the parable of the fig tree mean? What do not know? Well, let's see what this particular book is talking about and interpreting in the fig tree. And the master answered and said to me, do you not understand that the fig tree is the house of Israel? You see? Now, who said that it's not important if we're Gentiles or not? But here, as well as in the New Testament, it says about the same thing about the house of Israel. Do you not understand that the fig tree is the house of Israel? It is like a man who planted a fig tree in his garden, and it brought forth no fruit. And he sought the fruit many years. And when he did not find it, he said to the keeper of his garden, uproot this fig tree so that it does not make our ground unfruitful. And the gardener said to his master, let us rid it of weeds and dig the ground around it and water it. If then it does not bear fruit, we will straightway uproot it from the garden and plant another in its place, in place of it. Have you not understood that the fig tree is the house of Israel? Verily I say to you, when its twigs in the last days, then shall false Christ, I'm saying that on purpose, come and awaken expectations. False Christ. There are many false Christ. You all heard it on the news. You all seen this all the time, saying, I am the Christ who has now come into the world. And when they perceive the wickedness of their deeds, they shall turn away and deny him whom our fathers praise. The first Christ whom they crucified, and therein sin a great sin. But this deceiver is not the Christ. And when they reject him, he shall slay them with the sword. And there shall be many martyrs. Then shall the twigs of the fig tree that is the house of Israel shoot forth. Many shall become martyrs at his hand. Enoch and Elijah shall be sent to teach them that this is the deceiver who must come into the world, do signs and wonders in order to deceive. And therefore those who die by his hand shall be martyrs. and shall be reckoning among the good and righteous martyrs who have pleased the Most High God in their life. Chapter 3. And he showed me in his right hand the souls of all people, and on the palm of his right hand the image of that which shall be accomplished at the last day, and how the righteous and the sinner shall be separated, and how those who are upright in heart will fare, and how the evildoers shall be rooted out to all eternity. We beheld how the sinners wept in great afflictions and sorrow, until all who saw it with their eyes, whether righteous or angels, and he himself also. And I asked him, and said to him, Lord, allow me to speak your words concerning the sinners. It were better for them if they had not been created. And the Savior answered and said to me, Peter, why do you say that not to have been created were better for them? You resist the Most High God. You would not have more compassion than he for his image, for he has created them and brought them forth out of none not being. Now because you have seen the lamentations which shall come upon the sinners in the last days, therefore your heart is troubled. But I will show you their works, whereby they have sinned against the Most High. Okay, we're in paragraph 4. Behold, now what shall come upon them in the last days, when the day of the Most High and the day of the decisions of the judgment of the Most High God comes. From the east to the west shall all the children of men be gathered together before my Father, who lives forever. And he shall, let me just back up here a little quickly. Just kind of, hang on one moment, please, everyone. Just want to just kind of back up the way it's written. Okay, let's see, where am I? Did that the way it is written? It's like it's going up in a paragraph and moving on down. Okay, everyone according to his works. Okay, all right. And he shall command hell to open its bars of adamant. That's A-D-A-M-A-N-T. Forgive me for mispronouncing that wrong. And give up all that is therein. And the wild beast and the fowl shall he command to restore all the flesh that they have devoured, because he wills that people should appear. For nothing perishes before God, and nothing ceases. On the day of judgment, at the word of the Most High, and as all things were done when he created the world and commanded all that is therein, and it was done. Even so shall it be in the last days, for all things are possible with the Most High God. And therefore he said in the scripture, Son of man, prophesy upon the several bones and say to the bones, bone unto bone, in joints, sinew, nerves, flesh, and skin, and hair thereon. And soul and spirit shall the great Uriah give them at the commandment of the Most High. For the Most High God has set him over the resurrection of the dead at the day of judgment. Behold and consider the corns of wheat that are sown in the earth. As something dry and without soul, do men sow them in the earth, and they live again and bear fruit. and the earth restores them as a pledge, entrusted dies that is sown as seed in the earth and shall become alive and be restored to life, is man. How much more shall God raise up on the day of decision those who believe in him and are chosen of him, for whose sake he made the world? And all things shall the earth restore on the day of decision, for it also shall be judged with them, and the heavens with it. Wow. I tell you what, we are in chapter 5 and we are on chapter 4. Let's take a music break and we will be right back. You're listening to CSI, Crime Scene Investigation. You're listening to The Apocalypse of Peter right here on the Men Empowered Radio Show on the Blog Talk Radio Network at blogtalkradio.com.
From the minute that you born, your body starts to decay. Your skin and your hair would turn wrinkle and gray. One thing's for sure, we gon' pass away. That's right, dog, you wasn't put here to stay. I know you think you gon' live forever. You keep telling yourself you should chase cheddar. I can't front, I wanna be rich too. But I'm smart enough to know you can't take it with you. Got the cars, got the cribs. Ride through the hood and everybody know you're rich. Believe me, money do make life easy when you can make it rain like Fat Joe and Weezy. Brunch in Paris, dinner in America. This morning Chanel, but tonight it's Erica. I got ice in my Rolex, rims in the car. I could buy out the bar, show the world I'm a star. G4 flies to San Tropez. Look, I know you're trying to get paid. And all that money do sound real nice, but you don't got nothing if you don't got price.
Can't take it with you.
They wanna be, can't take it with you. They wanna be R-I-C-H. So don't store treasures in a place where it rots. Don't die and go to a place where it's hot. People think money's everything, but it's not. The things people do for the guap. Rap on, sell out their souls on a track. Some would even sell to their own mama crack. Rich people got it and they cheat on their tax. Girls sell their bodies and they lay on their backs. Some of them strip to make a porn flick fake like you're homeless and then walk with a limp. For oil and diamonds, so many died. So many nations face genocide, man. No matter how you get it, you're dead wrong if you think you can take it when you're dead and gone. All money does when they zip you in the plastic is
find you with something on the line with the gas.
Can't take it with you. They wanna be. Can't take it with you. They wanna be R-I-C-H. You got 24 hours, 60 minutes, 60 seconds. Your clock's ticking, time moves fast. And all the money in the world can't buy back a second of your past. Can't buy breath when you passing away. So tell me, what's the value of today? I discovered at last, you're really poor if all that you got in this world is cash. I got Jesus, I'm not a hostage. No longer living in bondage. Addiction's gone since I met the Savior. Believe me, I know all about favor. I know about joy, I can smile. I know about the Father's love for a child. I know what it's like to have bitterness gone. I know what it feels like to sing a new song. Rest in his arms, peace within. I'm a better man, yep, free from sin. In my life after, I'ma reign as a king. And I think it didn't cost me a thing. Cha-ching. They wanna be, they wanna be R-I-C-H. Come on, come on, hey. They wanna be, they wanna be R-I-C-H. Come on, come on, hey. They wanna be, they wanna be R-I-C-H. Come on, come on, hey. They wanna be, they wanna be all I see.
Welcome back to CSI Crime Scene Investigation, the music of Richie Righteous, You Can't Take It With You. I think that goes real well with the lesson that we're having on today. If you like to hear more of Richie Righteous, you definitely want to check us out on Saturday Night Gospel Jam. And we play that type of music every Saturday night right here on the Men Empowered Radio Show, brought to you by the Blog Talk Radio Network at blogtalkradio.com. We had Richie Righteous on our show back in 2010. 2010, we interviewed him and promoted some of his music as well as his new music there. Great brother. Hopefully I'll be able to share with him all of my new revelations to me that is new. It's new to me because I just woke up into the truth. So hopefully I will be able to share with him one of these days the truth about our people and our history. We are on the Apocalypse of Peter, chapter 5 or page 4, if you have a copy of the Apocalypse of Peter. Continuing on with just a few minutes, let's see how far we can go. And this shall come at the day of judgment upon those who have fallen away from faith in the Most High God and have committed sin. Cataracts of fire shall be let loose, and darkness and obscurity shall come up and clothe and veil the whole world. And the waters shall be changed and turned into coals of fire, and all that is in them shall burn, and the seas shall become fire. Under the heavens there shall be a sharp fire that cannot be quenched, and it flows to fulfill the judgment of wrath. And the stars shall be melted by flames of fire, as if they had not been created. And the firmaments of the heaven shall pass away for lack of water, and shall be as though they had not been. And the lightnings of heaven shall be no more. And by the enchantments they shall affire afright the world. The spirits of the dead bodies shall be like them, and shall become fire at the commandments of the Most High. And as soon as the whole creation dissolves, the people who are in the east shall flee to the west, and those who are in the west to the east. Those in the south shall flee to the north, and those who are in the north to the south. And in all places shall the wrath of a fearful fire overtake them, and an unquenchable flame driving them shall bring them to the judgment of wrath, to the steam of unquenchable fire with flows, flaming with fire. And when the waves thereof part themselves one from another, burning there shall be a great gashing of teeth among the children of men. And we are in paragraph 6 right here. Then shall they all behold me coming upon an eternal cloud of brightness, and the angels of the Most High who are with me shall sit upon the throne of my glory of my heavenly Father, and he shall set a crown upon my head. And when the nations behold it, they shall weep, every nation for itself. Then shall he command them to enter, let me back up this page here, to enter into the river of fire, while the works of every one of them shall stand before them. Reward shall be given to every one according to his deeds. As for the elect who have done good, they shall come to me and not see death by the devouring fire. But the unrighteous, the sinners, and the hypocrites shall stand in the depths of darkness that shall not pass away. And their chastisement is the fire, and angels bring forth their sins and prepare for them a place wherein they shall be punished forever, every one according to his transgression. Uriel, the angel of the Most High God, shall bring forth the souls of those sinners who perished in the flood, and of all who dwelt in all idols, in every molten image, in every object of love, and in pitcher, and of those who dwelt on all hills, and in stones, and by the wayside, whom people call gods. You see all these idols? I'm emphasizing that. They shall be burned with them in everlasting fire, and after all of them with their dwelling places are destroyed, they shall be punished eternally. Then shall men and women come to the place prepared for them by their tongues, wherewith they have blasphemed the way of righteousness, shall they be hanged up. There is spread under there, so that they do not escape it. Behold, another place, there is a pit, great and full. In it are those who have denied righteousness, and angels of punishment chastise them, and there they kindle upon them the fire of their torment. And again, behold, two women, they hang them up by their necks and by their hair. They shall cast them into the pit. There are those who plaited their hair, not to make themselves beautiful, but to turn them to fornication, that they might ensnare the souls of men to perdition. And the men who lay with them in fornication shall be hung by their loins in. Let me see. Bear with me one moment, please. Let's see. In that place of fire, and they shall say one to another, we did not know that we should come to everlasting punishment. And the murderers and those who have made common cause with them shall they cast into the fire, in a place full of venomous breasts, and they shall be tormented without rest, feeling their pains, and their worms shall be as many in number as a dark cloud. And the angel Israel shall bring forth the souls of those who have been slain, and they shall behold the torment of those who slew them, and say one to another, righteous and justice is the judgment of the Most High God. For we heard, but we believe not, that we should come into this place of eternal judgment. Paragraph 8. And near this flame there is a pit, great and very deep, and into it flows from above all manner of torment, foulest and excrements. And women are swallowed up therein, up to their necks, and tormented with great pain. These are they who have caused their children to be born ultimately, and have corrupted the work of God who created them. Opposite them shall be another place, where children still alive and cry to God, and flashes of lightning go forth from those children, and pierce the eyes of those who for fornication's sake have caused their destruction. Other men and women shall stand above them naked, and their children stand opposite and sigh and cry to God because of their parents, saying, these are they who despise and curse and transgress your commandments and delivered us to death. They have cursed the angels that formed us, and have hanged us up, and begrudged us the light which have which you have given to all creatures, and the milk of their mothers flowing from their breasts shall congeal, and from it shall come beasts devouring flesh, which shall come. Let's see, let me back up here. We're on the page of paragraph 8. And I think on tomorrow night, we will start on Tuesday. We will start in chapter 9, which will be page 5. And let me just go ahead and end chapter 8. Which will come forth and turn and torment them forever with their husbands, because they forsook the commandments of the Most High and slew their children. As for the children, they shall be delivered to the angel, that's T-E-M-L-A-K-O-S. And those who slew them shall be tormented eternally, for the Most High wills it so. Now this reminds me, all of this right here reminds me of the rest of Esther. It talks about the journey. It talks about the journey of to paradise, heaven, I mean going into paradise, which is Abraham's bosom on one side and hell on the other. Let me see if I can pull that up on tomorrow, and we will see the comparison of that. Let's take a break, and we'll give you our final thoughts right after this. You're listening to CSI right here on the Blog Talk Radio Network at blogtalkradio.com.
I'm about to lose my mind.
About to lose my mind. To all my haters,
it's been a long time, 13 years to be exact, patiently waiting to explode on a track. Do you even know what it's like, kid, to be a gospel rapper speaking fire, but you never get invited to any of the concerts, none of the conference? It shattered my self-esteem and lowered my confidence. I couldn't take no more. The devil said, rich, what you waiting for? He said, man, if you switch up your style, we could have these hits, we could stack these chips, and we could smash these chicks. Your young fly flashy and doing good music. If the church don't want your talent, then dog, I could use it. Besides, they're always trying to rearrange ya. I like the way you are, rich, I ain't trying to change ya. They never want to pay ya, they tell you come do it for Jesus, but in Jesus ain't the ring. Don't you want to drive a fast car and live like a rap star? I can put your name in lights galore. Man, what you waiting for? I said God's got a plan for me. Blessed is what I stand to be. God can put my name in lights galore, and that's what I'm waiting for. The devil said, so how long you gon' settle for being a broke musician? Savannah said you getting old and need college tuition. Gospel labels ain't signing, and you don't got a whack sound. It's just cause you don't got a choir in the background. So stick with me, and I can make a name for you. I made a lot famous, and I could do the same for you. Sign on the dotted and rhyme about any topic, anything that you need in this world, son, you got it. And if you wanna say you're a Christian and look shameless, just use the same excuse that I give these entertainers. Tell them you're a Christian and you really love God. You only do secular music cause it's just your job. So don't you wanna drive a fast car and live like a rap star? I can put your name in lights galore. Man, what you waiting for? I said God's got a plan for me. Blessed is what I stand to be. God can put my name in lights galore, and that's what I'm waiting for. I said devil, use a dirty, filthy, stinking, rotten liar. And if I follow you, I'll end up burning in the fire. I can't even believe you would try that, get me to make an Ishmael instead of waiting on Isaac. I rap for God and I do it well. I eat the magazine, but your boy double XL. And you hate that, you want me to trade that, but the fire is for you, Satan, and you cannot escape that. I'm a modern day Joseph, I can't be stopped. Throw me in a bit and I'll still come out on top, screaming Jesus is my hero, modern day Moses. So let God's people go, I'm modern day David. But when the pen is in my palms, these is more than rap that I write to call these songs. A modern day Samson, but when I hit the blocks, it's gonna take more than Delilah to pick my locks. A modern day Elijah, I could call down fire. Before the sonogram, he knew me like Jeremiah. A prophet to the nations, I'm patiently waiting for the day God comes back and smash you, Satan. A modern day Daniel, I could sleep among lions. Like them Hebrew boys, I walk through fire without crying. A modern day Paul, with a call on my life. John the Baptist, make way for the coming of the Christ. The price that he paid on the cross makes me rich. I don't gotta work with you to make hits. When it come to chicks, you already know the deal. I'm faithful to my wife. Besides, Ace is real. And even though sometimes I get hurt by the church, that still ain't gonna stop me, I'ma spit my verse. For Jehovah Jireh, the Lord's my provider. When it comes to this walk, the Malar is a rider. Don't you wanna drive a fast car and live like a rap star? I can put your name in lights galore. Man, what you waiting for? I said God got a plan for me. Blessed is what I stand to be. God can put my name in lights galore. And that's what I'm waiting for.
Patiently waiting.
The music of Richie Righteous again from that CD, Resting in Christ's Hands, the music, Patiently Waiting. Love that song. And once again, you can always hear music like that right here on Saturday night, Gospel Jam, 10 p.m. Central Standard Time, right here, brought to you by the Men Empowered Radio Show. So we're going to go ahead and just wrap it up here. Just want to send some shout-outs to everyone that is in Gary, Indiana, as well as greater Chicagoland. I know it's freezing up there, below 35 in some areas. How you doing out there? Saying hello also to the people in Detroit, Southfield, I got your back. How's everything doing? How's everybody doing in Farmington Heights? So got some other shout-outs. Don't know if I have time to go over there, but this particular shout out is if you are following me on Twitter, you know these people. I want to say, give a shout out to my brother here at edierock.com on twitter.com. He posted a dynamic website that I just fell in love with, do some more research and look things over. He found out that this particular, these slave ships, when we were brought from the continent of so-called Africa, when we were brought over here to ships, they record all the slaves on these ships. And how about these slaves got Hebrew names? I want to thank this brother for bringing this to our attention, because this is another nail in the coffin to let the people know, as well as our people, as well as the other people know, the Gentiles, to let them know who we are. We are Hebrew. For more information on that, you can go to slavevoyages.org. That's LAVEVOYAGES.org. So thank you, Brother Edie Rock, for bringing me that information. I appreciate that. And also, I just want to say hello to everyone else that is following me, or as I am following you on Twitter.com. It has been enlightening just to see what strolls down, because this kind of helps me through the day to see what everybody is posting, especially knowledge. We ought to not get satisfied with what we have learned. We should always, always continue to learn. We cannot exhaust learning from the Most High. Let me say this again. We cannot exhaust learning absolute knowledge and truth from the Most High. So I look forward to sharing with you all again tomorrow, the Apocalypse of Peter. Just want to let people know that we will be here on Tuesday with CSI and on Wednesday and Thursday with Let's Talk. Now, the mayor of New Orleans, Louisiana, the mayor of Hattiesburg, Mississippi. They have all shut down the city for tomorrow, getting prepared for this winter storm that is through the Gulf South. So you all know that we operate in the Gulf South, so all these areas are affected. From Texas all the way to the panhandle of Florida, we're under a winter advisory. They are talking about sleet and snow. So if we don't have any power outages, we will be here broadcasting the most high truth, absolute knowledge and truth. So look forward to being here tomorrow with the conclusion of CSI, The Apocalypse of Peter. We're going to get started in chapter 9, and it's going to be on page 5 if you have a copy of that. So it's all good. I look forward to seeing everybody again on Twitter. We are Men Empowered at twitter.com. Also, hit us up on Men Empowered 2 at instagram.com. And you can always let us know what's on your mind. You can email us right here at the Men Empowered Organization at menempoweredtoprosper@yahoo.com. And I also want to say that you can follow along with us on youtube.com by subscribing to Judah's Back as well as Jude Up. So look for those two brothers there. They're bringing great knowledge to the YouTube media, and not just the Men Empowered Organization, but they've got a lot of other Hebrew organizations that have music as well as knowledge that they bring it along. And yes, they do have the Gathering of Christ Church organization's teachings that are on there. By subscribing to Judah's Back as well as Jude Up, I think they have the largest catalog of teachings on Hebrew doctrines and everything like that, if you want to call it that. But the knowledge is there. So go to Judah's Back or Jude Up. They broadcast all of our broadcasts here at Blog Talk Radio Network. And it has been enlightening. I tell you, it's all good, Greater South. We're going to get through this thing. It's been cold. It's been cold before. So we're going to get through it. And the Most High will see you tomorrow. And if you haven't been baptized, you want to see about getting baptized, just send me an email and I can hook you up with some elders, and they'll know how to baptize you under the name of the Most High. So on that note, I will let you go, and we're going to send you off with Lionel Jones from the Papa Jones CD, On the Waterfront. Until tomorrow night, CSI, Crime Scene Investigation, will see you tomorrow night at 10 p.m. Central Standard Time, right here on the Blog Talk Radio Network. Shalom.